sunset high and I'm bloody low. Blood rush in the hazy glow. My hands still bones. Loose up, we break the scene. One step deep as you fall to me. Hot, hot, clap, we skip the beat. Count one, two, three.
What is up? It is Marissa Nicole and welcome back to my channel. Some of you may know me as My Drifting Desk, where I help you conquer college. And that's exactly what we're gonna do today as I dive into a breakdown of the Ohio State University's housing system. I wanna give you guys information on how the housing process works, information on Ohio State's learning communities, which are tied to the housing, information on Ohio State's Honors and Scholars program, which is also tied to housing. We're of course gonna dive into the pricing and different rates of the Ohio State dorms. And then I'm actually gonna go through each dorm on South Campus, North Campus, and West Campus to give you guys as much information as I can about kind of the amenities they have, the room styles that they have, bathroom styles they have, basically everything. If you're new here, hi, hello, my name is Marissa, and I'm actually a recent college graduate of Ohio State University. And for the past 5 years, I've been documenting my experiences, my time at Ohio State, everything on this channel. So if you're new here, definitely subscribe down below, check out my channel. I have Ohio State specific playlists, college vlogs, whatever you want to know, especially if you're coming to Ohio State, I have it here. And then coming up this summer, I'm also going to be giving you guys as much information as I can, because with everything going on, I know that incoming freshmen are not getting an in-person orientation and stuff like that, so I'm going to be going through a campus tour, basically like a virtual orientation, but here on my channel, from a student's perspective. So make sure you subscribe down below, turn on your post notifications, that way you don't miss those videos, and don't forget to follow me over on Instagram if you have not yet already. Before we get into the actual information, I do want to let you guys know that everything that I talk about, anything specific, is going to be linked in the description box, like those key websites, like housing, honors and scholars, learning communities, all of those sites basically, that you guys can look a little bit deeper into these topics. If I may have missed something or if you have any follow-up questions, definitely check out that, because those will be linked down below. But also, if you have any follow-up questions, definitely comment them. I always respond to every comment on every video, let alone this video. So if you guys have any questions about housing, I will do my best to try to answer them for Ohio State. The first portion of this video is gonna be basic housing information or key dates, stuff like that that you guys should probably know. And I'm gonna kick it off with, if you didn't know yet already, that Ohio State does have a 2-year live-in requirement at the main campus, so Columbus campus. So if you're coming in as a freshman, you do have to live on campus your freshman and sophomore year. Now, there are some exceptions to this. One of the most common being your sophomore year, if you do decide to rush a sorority or fraternity, you can actually live in your sorority or fraternity house, and that does count as your second year live-in requirement. And then there's also other caveats to that. If you do live in the Columbus area within like a 20-mile radius or so, you can apply to live, you know, off campus and not have to do that live-in requirement. However, those are handled on a case-by-case basis by housing directly, so you would have to contact them either via their website or phone number to see if that's something that you would be able to do. But if those do not apply to you, you will be living in a dorm your freshman and sophomore year at Ohio State. I'm not going to touch on the application process at all as far as like admissions into the university in this video. I do have other videos on that on my channel. However, once you have applied, of course, and you've been admitted into the university, so you've been accepted, once you pay your acceptance fee, that $100 acceptance fee, starting in mid-March, housing will begin to email students on a rolling basis based on when you pay that acceptance fee. So essentially, the sooner you pay your acceptance fee, the sooner you will receive housing information and be able to pick your dorm, essentially meaning that you will have the better choice of dorms if you pay your acceptance fee sooner. Now, those emails will be going to your Ohio State email, so your Buckeye Mail email, after you have paid your acceptance fee. Now, as you receive that email, it's basically your application to apply for housing. You're gonna go through different questionnaires, and I'm sure the application has changed a lot since I filled it out my freshman and sophomore year, but going based off of the application that I filled out, there is like a short questionnaire on it about, you know, what you are as a person. Are you clean? Are you tidy? Or are you more messy, essentially? Are you a morning person or a night owl? Are you involved in any clubs? Are you planning on taking a lot of 8 a.m.s? Like, stuff like that, so that way when you're filling out your application, housing can try to pair you with someone that will work the best for you. Now, there are areas to request roommates that you can do, and basically the key to do that is for you to request the roommate, and then, of course, for that person to request you on their application. And again, the sooner you do that, the better. Of course, that all kind of relies on availabilities of dorms, so if you wait until the last possible second, you might not be able to room with the people that you want to. Now, just recently, I got a comment on a past video of mine that I thought I should address here, because I'm not sure if people know this, but if you are part of the LGBTQ community, there is an area for you to identify yourself as that on the application. And likewise, if you do not identify as LGBTQ, there's actually another question that asks you if you don't mind rooming with or living with someone a part of that community. It's more so trying to make sure that LGBTQ students are going to be living with students who are accepting of them, rather than rooming them with someone that that's just gonna end terribly for the both of them. And in theory, it's meant to help the living situations on both parties, but especially those in the LGBTQ community. And when you're filling out the application, you're actually gonna be able to rank your top, when I did it, 3 houses in order. And then at the end, once you submit it, basically you will be billed for a $350 space reservation fee. It's basically like your deposit, your housing deposit, like you would be for renting an apartment or a house or anything like that. You will get it back at the end of your second year, so long as you haven't damaged your dorms or anything like that, where the dorms have to, you know, use that money. Now, once you make your selection, depending on, you know, when this happens, the actual assignments will go out again on a rolling basis based on people who have submitted those applications. And those don't start going out until the summer term, like, you know, summer, May, June, July kind of thing. But of course, you have to have filled out the application and paid your space reservation fee for your housing assignment to actually come to you. And then of course, every year, the move-in date into your dorms are gonna change, but it's always the Saturday before classes start, which start on usually like the third Tuesday in August. Before I move on to learning communities, if you have any questions that I didn't mention in that, you know, information portion, let me know down below and I can get back to you guys. But I do wanna mention some of the learning communities that are basically tied to dorms and housing within the university. A learning community is basically like a themed-based community that helps out students socially, culturally, academically, with leadership activities, and it's just a program to be a part of as a student. You can do it your first year and your second year. There are some that are only specific to first years, and then there's some that are open to both. There are 19 different learning communities, which I will link the website down below so you can read through all of them, exactly what they are. But a few of them may be women in engineering, first year collegiate, the visual and performing arts, and then you get to live in that specific dorm for that learning community. So you're kind of in and living with the community that you have joined. Not everybody in the dorm is a part of the learning community, but that learning community is housed in that dorm. So each learning community has its own dorm that it's tied to. If you're an incoming freshman, you do have to fill out an application to be a part of a learning community, and those are due usually sometime in April. But if you are a current student, so you're trying to sign up for a learning community your sophomore year, or if you're a campus change student, so coming over from maybe OSU Newark or OSU Mansfield, that application is due usually in January. I highly recommend checking out each learning community, reading about them, seeing if any of them interest you. It is not mandatory to be part of a learning community, but there's typically a learning community for everyone if you want to join. Moving on to the next thing that is tied with housing within the university is the Honors and Scholars Program. Now, the Honors and Scholars Program is actually two different programs. So there's the Honors Program and the Scholars Program. The Honors Program focuses more so on the academics or inside of the classroom. So you'd be required to take certain amounts of honors classes, but also while taking those honors classes, those classes are typically smaller. You get to have a more, you know, intimate classroom structure with maybe like 20, 25 people rather than maybe a 300 person lecture hall. You would end up graduating with the distinction of, you know, honors or graduating with honors. You have the opportunity to participate in a lot of research, and you get to write your own honors thesis within the program, and of course with help from faculty and staff within the program. And you get priority scheduling when you're in honors, so that means basically you get to schedule for classes sooner than students not in honors. If you're a part of the honors program, you actually have to live within the 3 different honors dorms. So there's one on North, one on South, and one on West campus. While you're in honors, you do have to maintain a 3.4 or 3.5 GPA depending on your major to, you know, continue being in the honors program. Now, the scholars program focuses more so on the community aspect. So what are you doing within the community, out in the world, not so much in the classroom? And there's actually 17 different scholars programs, all with different dorms attached to them. So you can check those out because, again, you will be living within that scholars house. Now, when you graduate after, you know, doing the scholars program, unfortunately you don't graduate with like a scholars distinction kind of thing like you would with honors, but you do get basically the recognition on your transcript that says this student completed the scholars program at The Ohio State University. The scholars also has priority scheduling, so you get to schedule ahead of time. And to stay within the scholars program, you do have to maintain a 3.0 GPA every semester. If you'd like to be a part of either the honors or the scholars program, because you cannot be in both, you do have to be in one or the other. Just like the learning communities, these programs are not necessary or not mandatory for students. And if you feel like doing it, you definitely want to make sure that you are applying to Ohio State by the early action deadline, which is November 1st every year. And on the application, there's actually a selection for you to indicate that you're interested in the honors or scholars program. And then you'd actually be prompted to fill out the extra honors and scholars essay, which on their website, they actually tell you guys ahead of time every year if you want to check that out on their website. If you are selected to be in the honors program, you will be notified on a rolling basis. So based on when students, of course, submit their applications and when they are admitted into the university, and those students will be notified between January and April. You will also be notified on a rolling basis if you are accepted into the scholars program between February and April via email. You are accepted on a competitive basis, and if you indicate that you're interested in both, you will only be admitted into one, like I said, and basically the university gets to choose for you. Now, before we actually break down the rates of the different dorm styles within the university, if you guys have any questions about the learning communities or honors and scholars and kind of the housing process and how that's kind of tied together, again, let me me know down below. Check out all the links down below. There's so much more information on the website that, of course, I don't have time to tell you in this video. Okay, so diving into the ranked system at Ohio State University, this is basically how they price out different dorms. Now, it's kind of confusing, but in layman's terms, Ohio State has essentially three different rates. Rate one would be the most expensive rate, and typically, you know, the nicest rate, the newer dorms with AC, more amenities, and then decreasing in price to rate three, which may be, you know, an older dorm, not as much amenities, and sometimes no AC. What also goes into this is typically how many people are living in those rooms. Usually, if there's more people living in the rooms, the price is gonna be a little bit lower because you're splitting that total cost amongst more people. Usually, single dorms might be a little more expensive, but again, it does depend on, you know, where that room is located in a dorm, if there's no AC, if there's more amenities, etc. But a rate one dorm costs $4,329 per semester. A rate two dorm costs $3,607 per semester. And a rate three dorm costs $3,371 per semester. And those are the prices for incoming freshmen for the fall of 2020. These prices actually change from year to year because Ohio State has a cohort system or a tuition price guarantee system, which basically means when you enter the university, your tuition and rates are locked until you graduate. And so each incoming class has a little bit of a different tuition rate and housing rate. You can just keep in mind that rate one is gonna be more expensive while rate three is gonna be least expensive. Rate one is gonna be nicer dorms. Rate three is gonna be maybe not so nice dorms. Now let's tackle the dorms. I wanna show you guys which dorms are located on which sides of campus, as well as maybe some of their key amenities, definitely whether they have AC or not, kind of their rooming styles, bathroom styles, and any kind of like key or fun information that I know or can find on the dorms. I'm gonna show them all on the screen here so you guys can kind of like follow them in a grid pattern, because hopefully that's easier for you guys to understand and to just follow. Maybe you guys can screenshot this if you wanna save it, whatever is easier. I just hope that this is useful information for you. It makes your dorm hunt a little bit easier maybe. And we're gonna start with my favorite campus first, which is South Campus. There is Baker East and Baker West Hall, Smith Steve Hall, Park Stradley Hall, Siebert Hall, Morrison Tower, Patterson Hall, Bradley Hall, Mack Hall, Canfield Hall, and the residence on 10th. South Campus is gonna be typically your cheaper dorms, while North Campus has a lot of the newer dorms and they typically all have AC, more amenities, but let's dive into those. There's Archer House, Barrett House, Blackburn House, Bowen House, Bush House, Drackett Tower, Halloran House, Haverfield House, Huck House, Houston House, Jones Tower, Lawrence Tower, Mendoza House, Norton House, Nosker House, Rainey House, Scott House, Taylor Tower, and Torres House. There are so many more dorms on North Campus than there is South Campus, and there was actually only one dorm without AC on North Campus. But West Campus definitely has the least amount of dorms because there's actually only two. There's Lincoln Tower and Morrill Tower. Before we wrap things up, I definitely want to give a little bit of background on me and where I lived or what I preferred. My freshman year, I was in the first year Collegiate, so FYC learning community, and I lived at Siebert Hall. I loved Siebert. When I moved in, it was, at, I think, 3 years newly renovated, so it was definitely clean, it was fresh, it was fun. It's the only freshman only dorm on campus, and the floors are separated by genders. There's a lot of dorms that do that, or like wing styles that are separated by genders, but there's also a lot of dorms that don't do that. I personally love South Campus just because I feel like there's much more going on down there. There's a lot more green space. You have Mirror Lake, the Union, a lot more dining locations in my opinion, and I just love the atmosphere of South Campus. Now my sophomore year, I actually lived on North Campus in Taylor Tower, which I also loved. Typically those room styles are quads, but I lived in a super double, which meant that I lived in a quad room, but only with two people. So there was a lot more room for the two of us because it was originally allocated for four. So that was great, but it was an older building, which of course I could tell by the styles of it, the floorings, the cabinetry, all of the things. It was definitely older. It got the job done. I enjoyed it, but North Campus just was not my style. It was very city-like, as you can hear. There was just so many dorms up there. There's also a lot of academic buildings on North Campus. That's where the Fisher College of Business is. And so to me, I like the greenery. I like the green space of South Campus, but that is just my opinion and where I lived my 2 years. I hope you guys found this video helpful. I hope it answered all of your questions. Like I've said multiple times throughout this video, if it didn't, please let me know if you have any other questions. I'd be happy to help you guys out in the comments or in my Instagram DMs. Whatever you guys want to know, I am an open book. My channel is an open book, so I highly suggest you kind of scroll through my videos, scroll through my Ohio State playlist, see if there's anything else that could help you if you're a new student to Ohio State. Congratulations, go Bucks. I just graduated in May, and I definitely wish I could go back and do it all over again. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so very much, more than you will ever know, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!
don't you stop the music, get into it, won't you dance with me? Find the bass and lose it, you can do it, won't you dance with me? Move your feet and feel it in the space between. You gotta give yourself a moment, let your body be.